Human dignity is defined as the inherent and intrinsic goodness found in every person due to being created in the image of God. It is both immeasurable and irreplaceable. No matter what happens, and no matter how low a person may feel in a certain point in their lives, this gift from God will never be lost. However, it is inevitable that anyone in a dire situation may feel and think otherwise. Whether the dilemma may be about their physical appearance, skills and abilities, their purpose in life, or their relations with the people around them, each one of us have moments when we doubt ourselves and our dignities. The following are examples of people who have experienced challenges just like the rest of us, but were able to bounce back and realize the true meaning of their dignity as God's children.
I sometimes wonder how different my life would be if I wasn't like this. Every day I look at myself in the mirror and think about everything I did wrong to end up this way. I can't remember a time where I was actually proud of my physique. Everyone else seems to be fine with how I look, but I would always think they're crazy for thinking that way. My health is worrying me. All I need to do is eat healthy and exercise, but somehow I can't. It's literally killing me.
Whenever I'd pass by the corridors during breaks for some valid reason, some of my classmates from grade 7 who encounter me often say, "Smart kid." It felt nice to be recognized for being knowledgeable and smart once in a while. However, deep inside me, I wanted more attention and recognition from many people for being smart. I kept telling myself that it was fine. It was fine to be smart for recognition. Time went by, and whenever I'd fail to boast my knowledge, the more it irritated me. I don't know when I'll be satisfied. When? How?
There was a time in my life wherein I recall the days that I considered the best in my life. Due to a pressure that I kept until now, I realized that I miss those days. The kind of day wherein I'll feel happy and relaxed after all the stress I've been through the whole day. The kind of day where I have someone to talk to whenever I'm feeling down. And the kind of day wherein I'll never be afraid to share my deepest emotions with the person I love the most.
I have this fear. I'm scared that I won't find fulfillment, that I won't find happiness, that I won't find my purpose. I feel trapped. Trapped in a situation where every choice I can make can only ever lead to what others want for me. I feel like I don't have a say. I don't want to end up doing something I hate. But it's so hard when what you're passionate about apparently won't get you a job, or won't get you money, or won't support a family. I guess it's true anyway. What is my purpose? What was I put on this earth for? Where will I find meaning? I don't know.
I knew that something was different about me growing up. I wasn't manly, didn't like sports, and generally just didn't fit in. It was in high school that I finally came to realize who I truly am, though this was a harsh realization. It made me take a long look hard at myself, and after many weeks of thinking, I finally knew who I was. However, knowing yourself was just the first part. Letting others know who you are is just as hard. I had so many thoughts then. Will they accept me? Is it wrong to be me? Will they leave me? Am I a burden? Disappointment? I told my friends, many of whom have stopped talking or remained distant, and eventually my family.
Am I good enough? Was I good enough? Will I ever be good enough? These three questions constantly linger through my head after every game. Time and time again, I read or hear little comments from my teammates who tell me that I wouldn't have made a difference at all. Though these are often meant to be passed off as jokes, there is still some sliver of truth behind it. It often happens after a game that I could not attend, and I usually get messages such as, "Oh, it's fine that you weren't able to go, we didn't really need you anyway." It is often comments like these that weigh me down and really leave a dark place in my mind.
Although I'm not doing well with my physical aspects, I seem to be doing well in everything else. I shouldn't let this one part of me define who I am entirely.
Slowly, my attitude about this changed with every guidance sessions. I slowly realized what I must hone my knowledge for. I know now to keep striving for the career path I want to take in the future.
But then, I quickly realized it was never my fault, and I had nothing to lose because that person was not really the one for me.
The power to decide and choose my fate and purpose will always ultimately be in my hands.
Even though I lost many of my old friends, I have now new friends that will accept me for who I am. And now I can finally say that I know who I am.
But now I realize that no matter what anybody says about me, I will always have my dignity. And that really is what motivates me to just practice, practice, and practice.